I'm delighted to introduce to you two beautiful portraits by Sir John Lavery. Firstly, this lovely little piece believed to be Mrs. Ralph Peto, and secondly, the stunning Mrs. E. Bowen-Davies. Now, this typical little 10x8 size canvas was very typical of the type of pieces that the artist painted in preparation for a larger canvas. More often than not, he would present it to the sitter as a memento for the sitting. It captured a fleeting moment of a personality, the sitter's pose and their garments, and it served as a beautiful gift to the subject. Now, this piece here depicts this lovely lady, hair tied up, garland on her head, a heightened makeup and a beautiful crimson dress. And it's likely that she was perhaps dressing up for a pageant or a charity event whereby she was recreating a pre-Raphaelite look. And such events were very popular leading up to the war, and indeed the artist's wife, Lady Lavery, attended on that social scene. Now, judging by the facial shape, the clothes, and the headgear and hairstyle, we believe that this is a portrait of Mrs. Ralph Peto, and it's based on a portrait that is recorded, a formal portrait, full size, of the sitter that was painted in 1910 and exhibited in the Royal Society of Portraits. Now, this lady here, we know that she was the cousin of Lady Diana Manners, and she was Lady Diana described as being very beautiful and spirited, and very much a social butterfly with plenty of suitors. She travelled on the continent with the Manners sisters on various tours of art galleries and famous European cities, and a very, very beautiful lady she is. And the brushwork here is stunning, and the heightened use of palette to highlight the lips and the crimson dress really bring out the striking qualities of this portrait. And moving on to Mrs. E. Bowen-Davies, what's interesting to note here is that this is a slightly later portrait, and we're moving into a different style, a different fashion. We're into 1923 here, and the Edwardian style of that grand manner portrait pretty much fell out of fashion almost overnight. We see at this stage the shorter hairstyles for women, less fussy couture, and it was all in accordance with the freedom that women were enjoying at this time. And of course, Sir John Lavery adapted his style, number one, in response to competition from younger artists such as Ambrose McAvoy and William Orpin, but also to reinvigorate his own style, so he very much embraced it. We see the sitter in just swathed in a black fur-trimmed cloak. Gone is the choker of yesteryear. She's wearing a simple single strand of pearls. Her presence fills the whole canvas. She's a very, very pretty lady and very elegant. Sir John Lavery knew only too well that black heightens and dramatises the flesh tones, and fur would also draw the attention to the upper part of her face and body. And of course, the pearls create a gentle reflection off the skin. And we see this colouring and type of clothing used over and over again. Indeed, just in our last auction, we had the beautiful portrait of Lady Parmore in her brown and black fur-trimmed garment, which sold for 50,000 at Whyte's. And what's interesting to note is the way he uses a single strand of pearls that's intertwined in her fingers, and it really elongates the form. And of course, we're drawn to this wedding ring here, which is shining with the beautiful heightened brushwork and paintwork. And that indicates that perhaps it was a portrait to celebrate the marriage of this young girl. Not a whole lot is known of the sitter, unfortunately. It was initially thought that she was related to the American artist Arthur Bowen-Davies, but that has not been fully confirmed. But nothing can take away from her the beauty and the glamour of the portrait. And we see this pose, the half-length pose, in later portraits by Lavery, but I think none come so far as the elegance and glamour that is depicted by Mrs. E. Bowen-Davies, and this is estimated at 30 to 50,000 euro.